Hola, bienvenidos a LightSpeed Spanish otra vez. Today I'm doing something a little bit different. You'll notice I've got a flip chart, no, a whiteboard with me anyway. Now, if you've been following our series on the indirect and direct object pronouns, okay, or as we know them to be, the furniture removers list or the shoot at me list, okay? If you don't know what that on earth that means, go back and look at the lay low mystery. Okay, now, I want to show you how you can identify a direct verb and an indirect verb. Why do you need to identify direct and indirect verbs? What it is, if you look at the furniture removers list, that's the mete le, nos os les, okay? To me, to you, to him. That list of pronouns that go on to add on to a verb, they add on to what we would call indirect verbs, okay? And the other list, which is the shoot at me list, which is mete lo la, nos os los las, okay? They bolt themselves onto direct verbs. Now, let me explain what that means, okay? Because it was a complete and utter confusion for me. Complete and utter. Okay, first of all, let me just go back a step. I want to explain something. You heard my little rant about grammar and the way that it's used and the names that are given, etc. Now, over and over in my classes, I have people who talk to me about direct and indirect verbs, and they start using explanations, they start using words like the object, the subject, okay? Now, I tell you what happens to me when somebody, and if people have been learning Latin, if they learned Latin a long time ago, they start talking about the accusative and the dative and stuff like that. Now, what happens is this. When somebody starts to talk like that to me, I get this kind of confusion in my mind. I get this blurry thing that goes on. Because why? Because I can't put an understanding onto that word. When they say dative or accusative or object or subject, I get confused. And when I look at the class, when somebody is saying, oh, well, you see, I think that's the object, and then I look at the class and I see there's a blank, crystalline, glassy-eyed look about people, okay? The same as I'm feeling. So I'm here to get rid of that. Look, let's stop complicating things. Let's make them easy. And I'm going to show you how to make them easy. Two kinds of verbs. Indirect verbs, direct verbs. Just have this in your mind. This is not grammar. This is my way of explaining it, okay? If you get an indirect verb, you're going to use the mete le, nos os les, the furniture removers. If you get a direct verb, you're going to use mete lo, la, nos os los las. Okay, simple as that. How do you identify a direct verb and an indirect verb? Let me show you a direct verb, okay? Now imagine we have one person here, very happy, okay? And then we have another person here, muy feliz. Okay, direct verbs happen between two people and nothing gets in the way. Nothing gets in the way. Let me explain. Look at this verb, ver, to see, okay? Now, Pedro sees Eduardo, okay? Pedro sees Eduardo. Now, Pedro can look directly at Eduardo and there's nothing in the way. Understand this figuratively, okay? It's a look. There's nothing that gets in the way. That's what's called a direct verb. So when you want to say, for quickness, as we said, pronouns are there. These pronouns are there to make your language quick. So You can say Pedro sees Eduardo or Pedro sees him. And this is where you have to choose him. Him. Is it le or is it lo? Okay, well, because it's a direct verb, it's lo. Why? How do you know it's direct? Because nothing comes in between. It's just look, all right? Also, change this one, okay? And let's say, we'll take the verb off, and let's do this one. Querer, oh, querer. To want or to love, okay? And this time, we'll say, Maria, okay? So the long version is, I've got Pedro, and it's not, it's Pedro. Dear me. Okay, Pedro. All right. Pedro quiere a Maria. Pedro loves Maria. But to make that quick, we would say, Pedro loves her. Okay? Pedro loves her. Or in Spanish, it would be Pedro, her, loves. Now, querer, is it direct or indirect? Well, if you love somebody, does anything get in the way? Is there anything in the way? No. It's direct. So, because it's direct, you're going to say la. Pedro la quiere. Loves her. Because this is a direct verb. Okay? So, direct verbs are simply this, that something, an interaction happens between two people or more, it doesn't matter, and nothing comes in between. They're not giving each other anything, they're not sending, they're not providing anything to anybody. It's just a direct action from one person to another. Okay? That's a direct verb. Now, let's look at the indirect verbs, because by seeing what an indirect verb is, you'll understand what I'm talking about. So, let's take this off. And we've still got Pedro and Maria. There's a bit of a love thing going on here. Okay. Now, an indirect verb, the reason it's called indirect, and understand that if you have an indirect verb, that means you're going to have to use le, okay, or les, indirect. An indirect verb means that something comes in between the action. That means that that person, imagine if you were, you know, a direct verb, you're looking at Maria, you could go straight over to Maria and there's nothing in the way, is there? Just you and Maria. But an indirect means something gets in the way. Okay, now, this is an ice cream. This is an ice cream, okay? Now, an ice cream is un helado, all right? So the verb is dar. Now, to give. In the verb itself, if you were going to give somebody something, and it can even be information, it can be anything, then something is coming between you and the person. And therefore, the motion from you to the other person is indirect because something's in between. It's indirect. So you know you must use le. So the sentence goes like this. Pedro le da a María un helado. Okay? Pedro le da a María un helado. Now, I'm not going to come in, I'm not going to shorten this too much because I want you to see what happens with the le, okay? I'm not going to get into the se. We'll talk about that in another time. Okay, so what happens is this. The sentence goes, all right? We know that it's indirect because there's something in between. There's an ice cream. So it would be Pedro, ¿vale? Le da un helado. Pedro gives her an ice cream. Pedro gives her an ice cream, okay? And it's le, it isn't la, okay? Why is it late? Because it's indirect. Something's coming in between. Okay? Now, let me show you something a little bit sort of more, not less clear, let's say, less clear. And that's this verb, decir. Now, decir is to say. So you would imagine, well, if you can say something to somebody, then it's direct because it's just you saying something to somebody. No, what you've got to think about is, what are you saying? You're saying something, okay? It isn't just like looking at somebody. You're actually giving some information to somebody, some piece of information. So what you've got to say is, in between that saying is info. It's indirect. Decir is always indirect. And because it's indirect, we've got to use le, okay? So what that would be, Pedro le dice que, bum, bum, bum. Puntos suspensivos. All right, so Pedro says to her that, all right? And this is to her. And remember, the furniture removers list is to me, to you, to him, to her, okay? So, Pedro le dice que, because he's giving her some information, therefore it's indirect. Now, let's just do some, I'll give you some verbs now. Based on what you've seen, I'll write some verbs and let's see if you can choose whether the verb is direct or indirect. Okay, and therefore, you would use either le for indirect or lo or la, depending on whether you're talking about a woman or a man. Okay, or los, or las, okay? But we'll just focus with le and lo, it makes it easy. Just, we want to be able to identify direct and indirect. So, what about this verb? Recoger. Okay, recoger. That verb means to pick up. So, the father picks up his children. So the father picks them up. Direct or indirect? What do you think? Is anything coming between the father and the picking up of the children? No. It's just literally an act between the father and the children. He's not giving them anything, he's not doing anything, he's just picking them up. So that's a direct verb. And therefore you would use los, because it's los niños. El padre los recoge. Okay? The father picks them up. El padre los recoge. Because it's direct, nothing in between. What about this verb? Enviar, enviar, to send, to send. What do you think? I send my mum a birthday card. I send my mum it. Yeah. Oh, I send it to my mum. Direct or indirect? Is there anything coming in between me and my mum? Well, yes, a birthday card. So it is indirect. Literally, you can imagine walking from the from you or the person who's doing it to the other person. If there isn't a straight line, if you have to walk around something, a bunch of flowers, a card, information, it's indirect. So that would have to be le, okay? So I send her a card. Le envío una tarjeta. A mi madre, if you want to put that on. But le envío una tarjeta. Not la, okay? Because it's indirect. Are you starting to get the idea of the difference between a direct verb and an indirect verb? Couple more examples, let's see. Preparar. Preparar. To prepare. So, he prepares his wife a coffee. He prepares his wife a coffee. Direct or indirect? To prepare? Well, can the man walk directly to his wife without having to walk around anything? No, he can't. There's a cup of coffee in the middle. So, this is an indirect verb. Indirect. Okay. And so, it has to be le. So, He prepares her, he prepares his wife, it. Or he prepares it for his wife. So, or let's say he prepares his wife a cup of coffee. He prepares her a cup of coffee. That's what we want to say. He prepares her a cup of coffee. Le prepara un café a su mujer. Extra information if you want. Le prepara un café. It's indirect. There's a coffee in between. Last one. What about mirar? Mirar. Okay. So, let's say John looks at, or Juan looks at Felipe. Okay? Juan looks at Felipe. So it's mirar. Okay? So it would be Juan looks at him. Direct or indirect? Is there anything in between? Can Juan walk directly over to Felipe? Yes. Obviously, look, if there were a building in between, well, you wouldn't be able to look at him, but if there were like a couple of fences, garden fences, you wouldn't be able to walk directly over, but that's taking it too far. Just literally, is there anything in between those two? No, he's just looking at him. So it's direct. This is a direct. And because it's direct, what are we going to use? Le o lo? We're going to use lo. Okay? So that would be Juan lo mira. Juan lo mira. Juan looks at him. This is the at, shoot at list. Okay? Now, how does that sit with you? Can you now start to see the difference between a direct, whoosh, an indirect, round something? Yeah. As soon as you know that, it's now you can identify the verbs, then you can start to put in the right pronoun from the right list. I want to finish just with one thing, okay? And I want you to bear in mind that the only confusion that occurs is in third person. What I mean by that is he, she, or they. That's the only confusion, because all of the rest don't have this issue. Because if I say, he makes me a coffee, or he looks at me, there is really no difference. It's just me. It's always me. All right? You don't have to worry about, is it me or something else? There's only me on the recipe. Me, te, nos, os. They're always the same. So you don't have to worry about them. The only things that you have to worry about is this. Third person, he or she. Is it le, lo, or las? And they, is it los, las, or les? All right? That's all. Everything else just is standard, okay? And you'll find that there'll be no issue with those. All right, so I hope that's helped, direct and indirect. If you have any questions, post them on the video or on our website, okay? Ask a question if you're not sure about anything. In my experience, if you can have clarity, you can build on it. When you have confusion, you can't build on confusion. If you're confused about something, you become stuck, okay? Confusion's great, but you must get out of confusion into clarity. And this is what I'm aiming to do by doing this. All right? So I'll see you in the next video. Watch on.